guys, welcome to another video. It's time for part 6. Hey guys, we're painting all the horns and the spiky bits today. So I'm starting off with a mix of dark brown, a little tiny bit of dark sea blue, and a little bit of buff, just to try and get a slightly different bluish greenish tone to this sort of brown sort of base mix that I'm using for the bones. I'm painting these all over, painting nearly every part of it, just leaving little tiny parts of the dark sea blue showing through. And I'm not worrying too much about the lines on things or the shapes of things too much. I'm just trying to get a good covering here. The paint's not really thinned down too much. There's only sort of the water from the wet palette that naturally comes up into the paint here. Now, for the first light or highlight here, I've just added in part of buff to this now to get a much lighter tone. Buff is quite a strong sort of yellowish, whitish sort of parchmenty colour, which I use for bones and things all the time. It's a really nice paint to use. But here I'm focusing more on getting the lines on the spikes and the bones, and concentrating the light more towards the top of the bone areas and towards where the light would hit the most. Now the paint here again, it's not thin too much, just naturally with the water from the palette. And I'm just slowly building up the layers on top of each of these spiky bits. If it's not what I think is light enough, I'll go back and put another layer on, just to build up the opacity on these spikes. And here is the last highlight, which is almost pure buff now. And I've thinned this down a little bit so it goes on nice and smooth and thin. And I'm just really just painting the tips of these bones. It's very simple to do these guys, and it looks quite effective when it's done. So just take your time with the last layer to make sure you get the little thin lines on the spikes. And they look pretty cool then when they're done. And here is the final finish of the bones, guys.